Hey there, it's Rebear, and welcome to today's video. I'm very excited about this one because I am continuing my list of authors that I have not read from before. I made a video like this a while back, and I am working on going through those authors, but it wasn't until I really wanted to make a second list that I realized that I should have organized it a bit differently. So I've done that now, where I've prioritized authors that I plan on reading from in the near future. I'm going to be organizing this list in order from the most number of ratings to, or the least number of ratings to the most number of ratings, so basically in order of popularity. And then I'll give you how many, or what their average rating is, how many ratings, and list off some of their works and the things that they've written. And mention how many distinct works it has listed. Now, some of them are distinct, but they're actually just the same book in a different language. Sometimes they get listed a little funky on Goodreads, so keep that in mind. And some of them are like anthologies and stuff like that that they wrote on, or short stories, or, you know, flash fiction things that somebody has added on here because they wanted to track it on their Goodreads. So it's not this number of actually, you know, full on novels, but it gives you an idea of what we're working with. If I have a book that I currently own that I want to read for that author, or that I plan to read for that author, then I will tell you that. If not, then I'll tell you kind of what I have in mind. So I'm still working on list number one as far as reading those books, but I did want to go ahead and make list number two because there are some authors that are super popular right now that I know I'm going to want to get to. And also I have books for some of these authors that there are authors from video one that I didn't have their books yet, that I don't have their books yet, and so I can't get to them quite yet. And then there are authors from this one that I also don't have their books yet that I can't quite get to yet. So I'm hoping that if I make the part two, then I can come back and update, and it be like a mixture of the two lists, and it be like the 20 authors total. And then by the end of the year, maybe I could have even finished all of them. That would be cool. And then next year I could start fresh with new authors that I need to get to. Maybe. We'll see. We'll see. I still have a ton of other authors that I have the idea to include in this series of videos of authors that I haven't read from before, that I've kind of created a series out of that I wasn't originally planning on doing, but now it's a series. So anyways, if you want to see the list from last time, make sure to click the link. There will be one in the cards. I can't remember which side it's on. Okay, now my computer's right over here, so if you see me glancing, that is what I'm looking at. Let's go ahead and get into the list. The first author that I have is Renée Adier. Renée Adier has 416,636 ratings on Goodreads with an average rating of 3.95. That average is across 26 distinct works. Works include The Wrath and the Dawn, which is a duology, The Flame and the Mist, which I believe is a duology as well, The Beautiful, which is a trilogy. Of this author's works, I do have the second book in the Wrath and the Dawn duology, but I don't have the first book. But I also do have one of her other books, and that is the first book of The Beautiful. And this, I believe, if I remember correctly, is a vampire like resurgence situation, like a angsty vampire vibe story. So I'm totally down. I have been into angsty books lately, like over the top, extra obnoxious, problematic, don't mind. I don't mind. The next author on the list is Grady Hendrix. Grady Hendrix has 480,026 ratings with an average rating of 3.77. It is across 44 distinct works. There are so many books by Grady Hendrix that I want to read, and Grady Hendrix is an author that is, I feel like, one of Lala's like go-to authors that she's read a lot from. The most popular of her works is The Southern Book Club's Guide to Slaying Vampires, which I'm so excited for. As a Southern girly, I really want to read it. There's also The Final Girl Support Group, her second most popular, followed up by My Best Friend's Exorcism, which I have on my list. And I have seen in Barnes & Noble on an end cap multiple times, and I've really struggled to not go ahead and pick it up And then we have Horror Store, which I am super intrigued by. And that one has like a lot more visual elements to it. How to Sell a Haunted House, which is her release from this year. I do not currently own any, but as I just listed a bunch, now that I'm talking about it, it kind of gives me the excuse to buy them now. The next author we have is Kate Atkinson with 672,968 ratings, an average rating of 3.8. What's interesting to me about this one, Kate Atkinson's number of distinct works is 75, which really confuses me because there are so many books here listed and everything, but I don't know about any of them. The book that I'm interested in by this author is Life After Life. It's actually a duology and I have both. I don't really know of her other works. There are more listed, but I don't really know anything about them. Case Histories, which is a Jackson Brody series. I don't know anything about that. Behind the Scenes at the Museum, no idea. I really only know about this one. That's the only one I know about her. The next author is another one that I do have a book for. I actually have two, and I have multiple things that I know I want to read from this author, so I'm very excited to talk about them. And that is Neil Schusterman. I am so excited to dive into some Neil Schusterman. For Neil Schusterman, we have 83 distinct works, 4.23 average. Some of his books include a series called Arc of a Scythe. It's a trilogy. I have Thunderhead, the second book, but I don't have the first or last yet. There's another one called Unwind. I don't really know anything about that. Everlost, part of the Skinjacker series, I don't really know anything about. Challenger Deep, which I have heard about and is on my list. Full Tilt, I think I've heard of that one. The one that I own by him is called Game Changer. I'm very interested in, I believe it's about a boy, yes, on his high school football team, and it's like it's like he's in another dimension or something, but he ends up in like lots of different universes that are not really his own, and it sounds kind of like along the lines of like the Midnight Library and Jane Unlimited, which is totally my vibe, because that concept of like all the options and like struggling to choose between them and, you know, wishing you could see what life would be like if you had chosen something else, like all of those things, conversations that I struggle with decisions because I struggle with the reality that I will never know what the right decision is in terms of what the outcome would be. It's ridiculous. But I really love books that explore that concept. The next author that I have is Celeste Ng. Celeste has 1,659,401 ratings. Not 401, 401 ratings. I always want to say and when it's not supposed to be and, because you're only supposed to say and if it's a decimal point. But living in the South, sometimes you hear it so much incorrectly that it gets in your brain. Celeste Ng's average rating is a 4.0. A 4.0! That is insane for an average rating. What's really crazy for Celeste Ng is that is literally, that 4.0 is over 15 distinct works. 15! Children, 15. How do you have a 4.0 average rating with literally like three novels and then everything else that you have in your 15 distinct works is not a novel? I think my interest in Celeste Ng mainly stems from Kayla from Books and Lala, but I do have two books from them because I ordered them on Book Depository when I was placing an order. They were on sale, so I went ahead and picked them up, and that is Everything I Never Told You and Little Fires Everywhere. They released a book in 2022 called Our Missing Hearts, which I'm also interested in. They have also written in a few different anthologies. Next up we have Victoria Aveyard. Victoria Aveyard has a 3.93 average rating. Victoria Aveyard only has 25 distinct works, which is definitely on the lower end of things. That does include, I believe, a couple of anthologies. What I have from her is Red Queen and Glass Sword, the first two books in the Red Queen series. This is like the only series from her aside from her more recent series that she started, which is called Realm Breaker. She's released two books in that. I'm guessing the third book comes out this year. I don't know if it's a duology or a trilogy or a what, but I'm guessing the next book would come out, and I don't really know. The next book comes out probably this year or next year. So she is still publishing, but she's, you know, she took a hiatus in between this series and her newest series. We're gonna jump up to an even higher rated, much more popular author, and that is Gillian Flynn. 4,851,468 ratings with an average 4.6 rating. Gillian Flynn's 4.6 average rating, despite having millions, almost 5 million people reading and rating these books. And it's only 26 books that they're pulling from here. And that, again, includes anthologies and things. Of her books, I'm interested in several. Gone Girl, Sharp Objects, I have a copy of somewhere, but I didn't pull it down. So I might start with that, but honestly, I feel like Gone Girl is the one that I would need to do a first time reads video for because it is so popular. It's like got almost 3 million readers. So I feel like it would be a good first time reads video. Dark Places and The Grown Up, which is a short story that is in another book. Like it's in an anthology and then she pulled it and made it its own book. This is one of those things that even if you know me, you may have chosen to block this from your memory because you don't want to accept it. Taylor Jenkins Reid. I have not read a Taylor Jenkins Reid book. 4,851,935 ratings with an average 4.26 average rating. I do own two books, one physically and one digitally, from this author. One of them is The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo, which is by far and away her, you know, the book that got her attention. Yes, I chose to not read it because of the hype. That is correct. Yes, I still struggle with my reading hipster syndrome. Where I don't want to read it because it's popular. Yes, I chose to not read it because of the hype. That is correct. Yes, I still struggle with my reading hipster syndrome. Where I don't want to read it because it's popular. But I'm gonna read it! I'm gonna do a first time reads video for this book. And it will be coming. If you are excited for that, please make sure to leave a comment down below letting me know so that I will bump it up in priority. There is also Daisy Jones and the Six. I'm probably not going to read that one because it's much less popular, I feel like, personally. But the main reason is because I'm not interested in it for the fact that it's music industry related, and it can be very difficult for me to read things that are music industry related sometimes because, or in general, it can be difficult for me to read things that have to do with things that I'm involved in. So because I'm involved in music, it's hard for me to read books that are about music sometimes because I nitpick and I am being very picky because, you know, you don't know what the author's knowledge basis is from, whether it's from personal experience, whether it's from research, you don't know. And it can be so frustrating and I sit there and I think about it too much and I nitpick a lot about things like that. So probably not going to focus on that. Malibu Rising, which has some of the characters from one of the other books. I don't remember which one. And then One True Loves, Maybe in Another Life. And then After I Do, which is one that I am more interested in. I actually have that one on my TBR list at the moment. And then The Evidence of the Affair, I own digitally. The next one is another classic author. I had an author of classics in the last round, so it only seemed right to continue that trend and have another author of classics in this round as well. And for this round, I decided to go with C.S. Lewis. C.S. Lewis has 7,236,268 ratings with an average rating of 4.17. C.S. Lewis has a little bit more of a logical reason to have so many ratings, and that is because he has 975 distinct works. The Chronicles of Narnia, I have never read them. And yes, I'm interested in them. Also, The Screwtape Letters, Mere Christianity, A Grief Observed. My sister has read C.S. Lewis. I have not. That's weird for her to have read an author and I haven't. And finally, we finish off with an author that has 12,201,435 ratings. Put your guess in the comments below who you think it is before I say it. Put your guess. I will wait. Who do you think it is? Next clue, an average rating of 4.2. Are you ready? Colleen Hoover. I have never read a Colleen Hoover book. And furthermore, 12 million ratings? What the heck? I knew she was popular, but like, how? How do you have that many ratings? Baffles me a little bit because she only has 94 distinct works. Lots of popular books. Colleen has had a huge resurgence in the last year or so, the last like 2 years. Popularity really, you know, skyrocketed. A lot of her older books getting, you know, refreshed, resurged, it's because of the TikTok, you know, the TikTok things where older books have been, you know, revisited, or people are like bringing back and remembering, mentioning them again, or are getting to them finally now, even though they, you know, came out a while ago, and like people reading backlist books. And then, yeah, you get it, right? Right? Okay, great. It Ends With Us, which is a series. Duology, maybe? I don't know. Verity. Ugly Love. Reminders of Him. November 9th. Hopeless. Regretting You. All Your Perfects. Maybe Someday, which is a series. Or duology. Confess. Heart Bones. Slammed. Layla. Point of Retreat. No, that's Slammed too. Without Merit. Too Late. Never Never, which is like a three-parter situation. That was with Taryn Fisher. Okay, that's it. That's what I got for you. If you did not see the first 10 authors, please make sure to check that out so that you can keep kind of an eye on the books that I'm talking about. I have been working on going through those, and I will be continuing to do that as well as this one. I would love to do like an update in maybe another couple months of where I'm at on these authors. Maybe I can at least have half of the 20 done. I'm done rambling now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have a great rest of your day or night, whatever time it is for you. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and join the Bear Scouts and the notification bell down below so that you'll be notified when I post, but more importantly, so that I can see you again very soon. Peace out, Bear Scouts.
With just the bare necessities of life. Yeah, with just the bare necessities of life. Yeah, man.